Well, there's the box. Yep, I just unboxed this. I've been waiting and waiting. And actually, I began to wonder if I actually even ordered this pack. And then I looked, and I had a few that were on in my carts. And I'm thinking, man, that thing should have been here by now, because I'd ordered other things too, which is what's amazing is everything showed up today. I got another herb shipment in. I got some ear candles, which I'll have to show you all about that. But this is the pack. This was this from Stealth Angel. Maybe you've seen them advertised. They sell other type products too, you know, for camping and survival and that sort of thing. So this was the Stealth Angel pack. $29.95. That's hard to beat. I think it was $9.95 shipping too. But let's get a look at the bag a little. Now, when I first looked at it, compared to my old, well, I got it over there now. My old original bag, there was a computer bag. This didn't appear to be that much bigger at first. But it actually is. This thing's got a lot more room. You know, once it expands here, yeah, let's see. Wish I had a camera stand. But see, when you pull it out, here. When you pull it out there, it expands pretty good. Even this pocket will expand considerably more here on the front, the top pocket. So that's what it's got. You got a top pocket up here. That'll probably be maybe first aid and fire starting for me. You got this large pocket in the front here, which may or may not. That'll probably be my food. I don't know. Already I've been taking some of my extra gear out. I got it laying over on the couch. And I'm getting ready to put some things in here. But then you have two other bags here. You got the medium-sized bag along that zipper. And the larger bag along this zipper. There is a pouch here you could use for hydration in the back. Goes down in here. Thing is, there's not really a hanger for your bag. I mean, you could put a carabiner in here and hang it. But then this is going to interfere with your Velcro closure because this is a Velcro closed bag. So I'm not sure if I'll put a bladder in there. More than likely because this doesn't really have this is a frameless backpack. I'll probably take my backup large tarp with me. But instead of it being rolled, it'll be folded up so that it goes in here and keeps any hard things from resting against my back. And then we'll see what else I'll put in there. And then inside of that, well, I'm not sure. Not sure just how I'm going to pack it. Now, let's talk about some things I don't like. Well, it had a piece of loose thread up on here. I think I might have taken it off. Maybe it's on the other one. But that's no big deal. The D-rings on here, they're a little flimsy from what I'm used to, it seems, but I think they're going to be fine. I can't tell now if they're metal or plastic. I think they're plastic. The buckles are okay. The straps are okay. None of it anything special. You know, I have much better straps on some other things. But one of the things I don't care so much about this, or that I wish was improved, is that you got these compression straps on the side, on the bottom on each side. A lot of similar bags have two of them, one down here and one up here higher on the back, which is great because then you can put your gear in here, whether it be sleeping mat, all kinds of things, a tarp that you could put in there, hatchet, but this only has the clip at the bottom, unfortunately, the compression strap, I mean. And the other thing about it is, once this bag is full, you're not going to be able to put anything big in there, I don't think. Now, fortunately, there is some moly tie downs on here, which is a good thing. My other bag has some daisy chains, but it doesn't really have moly. So now I'll be able to stick. I have other bags that are about this color. I'll be able to put them on here on the sides for extra storage, or I could hang them here on the back, or here, or even here. Now, one thing I did find a little strange. Like I said, there is an opening back here for your hydration bladder. There's not an internal one. So there's no place here. You just have to run your hose out. You know, you could run it and attach it to your straps. But it's funny because right here at the top, underneath the grab handle here, is what looked like it was originally designed to be a pouch for your water tube to come through. And it's open on the one side here. I can get my finger in, but it does not go all the way through. So yeah, I'd imagine if you had a bladder inside the bag, you could just poke a hole down underneath there, right up in there, and just run your bladder hose right out of that. The other thing for cinching, now that at least the straps, you can tighten them top and bottom, which is very important. Some cheaper ones, they don't have a means to pull it up to your back on the top. And then, of course, you got this long strap, which I guess you would be able to put something underneath here across the back of your pack. So that's what I got so far with this. There are a couple of loops here on the end on the top of the bag where I could no doubt run one on each end. I could run some paracord through there and use that to attach something on the top of this bag. So far, I tell you what, for the price, for $29.95, I'm not upset. Now, I will show you this. This stuff's not going to last long. Here, let me set you down a minute. A lot of this type of plastic waterproofing that they have in here, I can just see that, you know, that's not going to last 2 years, I don't think, before it's coming off in some places. And up here, you just have a little a zippered pouch. It's not that big. It doesn't run the whole bag. It's maybe 4 inches deep. And the rest of this is all open, the main compartment. And you do have a mesh bag on this side to help give a little organization. Because I do like organization with my packs. I actually prefer things that are very compartmentalized. And like I said, even with this, I will attach a couple other bags I have on the outside of this pack, most likely. I'm not sure. Wait till I get it packed up, and I'll make up my mind. And here's your next pouch. You know, here's the big one down here. It's pretty deep. I forget the actual dimensions, but it's pretty deep. Then you got this pouch here. And once again, it has a little mesh, a pocket back here and a small mesh pocket, or two little mesh pockets on the front of there. And that's it for in here. But like I said, this type of stuff, sure, it's going to be waterproof, but how long is it going to last? That's right. For me, this is just for me to be able to get out there and do some camping, because my inch bag is way too big to take out camping. So here on the bottom, you have another large bag. Don't know if you can see that. And this is thick enough where actually my fist sitting sideways like this will fit in there. So it's deep. Now, if I pack the rest of the pack too tight, then I won't have that much room. And then, like I said, up here on the top, you have this other little pouch. Like I said, that'll maybe be for first aid, water, fire, something along those lines. First aid would no doubt be in there. And we'll figure the rest out. Like I say, I've already dug up some of my extra gear. I have it sitting on the couch. I'm going to go and start putting things in here. And what's good about it is that my big inch bag there, wow, that thing's still way too heavy with everything I got in there. Even though I just took 8 ounces out of that first aid kit, it's still way too heavy. Of course, my fire kit has way too much stuff. So I'm going to take some of that out, put it in this bag. I've already taken out a lot of first aid. I'm not sure where I put it. I was just looking for it. I have another separate first aid kit, a backup one. Oh, now I know I stuck it in the van. Yeah, but I have plenty of extra first aid. So I will make up a kit to put and keep in this bag. That way I don't have to carry this big one around with me. This is for an inch bag in case... I mean, that's a long-term situation. There could be other people getting hurt. So that's what that's for. That's not just for personal stuff. So anyway, that's what I got right now on this bag. Like I said, Stealth Angel. I've gotten other things from their company before. I think it may be the same company that does the, I'm not sure, but I think they're related to the same company that does these knives here, these Evatech knives. Very heavy knife, but much heavier than what I'm used to carrying, much larger, but it is heavy duty, very easy to open. I keep it extremely sharp, especially up here, this edge here. Yeah, I could skin an animal with that. This part here, because I'm always cutting so many things with it, it tends to get wore down the quickest. But yeah, it's a very solid knife. Got the seatbelt cutter there and the glass pommel here on the back. And I think these were about $12.95. So I'm not complaining. Like I said, and it's a very thick, 1/8 inch thick blade. It is heavy. Hey, if you ever had to pull it out for self-defense, it'd be quite intimidating. Yeah, here, I'll show you. Let me see. This is one of my old, really cheap carries because I just use these for tools. They're not really, I don't carry them around for defense or offense, but this is the old one I was carrying. It is super light, but the blade is very thin. Nothing wrong with that. And these just aren't strong. These came in a set with a bunch of knives. I've already broken a couple of them. This one here, heck, I believe I could baton wood with this and not have to worry about it. A little word of advice. If you are going to do that to wood with a folding knife, preferably turn it this way and put this on your log and then bang on it here, as opposed to having a knife straight like this and maybe damaging your mechanisms in here. All right, so that's it. Stealth Angel Pack. Hey, for $29.95, I don't think it was a bad deal. I think it was another $9.95 for shipping. But so far, I like it. I'm going to be testing it out. If it wasn't so late today, I'd be going camping with it tonight. I have a nice little stealth camp set up not too far away. But I'm going to go ahead and set some stuff in it tonight, which is good because I'm going to take a lot of weight still out of this bag. I absolutely have to. That thing, I'd carry it. But I don't know how far I'm going to carry it. I've gone on a couple of mile hikes. I know that I could go further. But wow, I think 5 miles, I'd probably have to make a couple of stops along the way. So a good thing is I'm going to take some things out of that monster and put them in here. This would be for my camping. That's when the doo-doo hits the fan. All right, I hope y'all are prepared for whatever might happen. And the best ways to do that for what is coming is you need to be reading your Bible, you need to be praying, and you need to be turning away from your sins. Hey, all those things will make the world a better place. All right, folks, that's it. Subscribe. Hey, stay tuned. I'm going to show you some more things on camping gear. Of course, I'm going to bring you plenty more of the Word of God. And I still, it's going to take time. I mean, I still have some unboxing videos to do, but I so much want to get out the video that I uploaded before where the sound didn't come out, where it shows lots and lots of things that the Bible says about bugging out in the last days. You're definitely not going to want to miss that one. That's a one-of-a-kind video. All right, folks, that's it. Subscribe. Yep, see some other videos. And be walking with God. Amen.